In the previous tutorial, we learned how to calculate the frequency for the variable gender. And this was the data set that we used. So we already know that we had 8 males and 12 females, and our total number is 20. So what we're going to learn in this lesson is how to effectively display that information so that people can get information from that. So we're going to do this in two ways. We're going to learn how to create a table and how to create a chart or a graph. So let's start with the table. How do we create a table that displays this information effectively so readers can get something out of that? We're going to start with the table, and we're going to display all of our information. So I'm going to create a table here. I'm going to call it Table 1, and I'm just going to call it Frequency of Gender. And as we'll see here in a moment, every table needs a title. And we have our variable gender, and we have two categories for that variable, in this case male and female. And we're displaying the frequency, so one of our labels here is frequency. We also calculated percentage, so we'll include that, and we'll include our total. So we're just going to fill in our numbers here. The number of males was 8, the number of females 12, and the total was 20. Our percentages, if you recall, were 40% and 60%. 8 over 20 is 40.4, 12 over 20 is 0.6. That's where those numbers came from in the previous video. And I'm going to include one more thing, source. And I'm just going to call this statistics class survey. We now have a table that is referred to as a frequency table that gives us a lot of information about this variable gender. It tells us how many males there are, how many females there are, what percentage males make up, and what percentage females make up. I also want to note a couple of important points about this table. Every table and every graph that we create needs to have some important elements in it. And those elements are this. It needs a title. We always need a title. We need a total. We need to know the total number of observations this data represent. We need labels, and we need a source. So here's our title, number one. It's Table 1, and that title says this is the frequency of the variable gender. And we have a total here, and we can see that our data and our percentages come from a total sample size of 20. We have labels. We know that these numbers represent frequencies. We know that these numbers, 40 and 60, are percentages. We know that this row represents males, and this row represents females. Labels are very important. We need to know what the numbers are, what the categories are. And then finally, we have source. We need to tell the reader where these data come from. Those are the four components, aside from the actual numbers that go in the table, the four elements that need to be in every table and graph that we create. So we've just created a table to display our frequency distribution for gender. Let's now create a graph. We can display this information. Sometimes we display it tabular form, sometimes graphical form. Graphs are handy because they display a lot of information very quickly. So we're going to create this graph. There's my vertical and horizontal axis, and I've got tick marks here. We already know that we need a title for every table and graph that we do. So this is Figure 1, and I'm going to call it Frequency Distribution for Gender. And we have two categories of our variable gender, male and female. And we know that we're displaying frequencies here. So I'm going to label my axis, and I'm going to label these tick marks here. Now, to do the graph, we know that we have 8 males. So I'm going to draw a bar. This is a bar graph up to the 8 point here. We do the same thing for the females. Females, there are 12. If you want, you can include the n or the number here. So what we need to complete our graph here, we need source. statistics class survey, n equals 20. We've now completed our graph and we have the same information. We can visually look at that and see very quickly that females, there are more of them than males, and there's 12 females versus 8 males. And our graph has all the features we need in terms of a title, a total, labels, and a source. We have all the components we need.